Good afternoon to all. My topic is an aid for the abused victims. Traumatic events are common and can have lasting effects on person's life, health and mental well-being. The effects of trauma go far beyond its immediate psychological, physical effects. In addition to physical injury, violence have lifelong health and psychosocial effects. Individuals who have experienced repeated chronic or multiple traumas are more likely to exhibit pronounced symptoms and consequences, including substance abuse, mental illness, and health problems. Being a victim of an abusive and traumatic event can also increase an individual's risk of further abuse and of becoming perpetrator of violence. The burden of violence, abuse, and trauma can extend not only families, friends, but society at large, including public services that deal with the ongoing impacts of violence, for example, criminal justice agencies and health, social, and welfare services. Identifying, caring for, and supporting victims of violence with evidence-based initiatives is thus crucial in protecting health and breaking cycles of violence. Victims of violence, abuse, and trauma require care from a health professional who is trained to treat the trauma associated with the wrong that has been done to them, be it sexual assault, intimate partner violence, neglect, or other forms of intentional injuries. A wide range of public health practitioners, researchers, and systems have set themselves to the task of understanding the roots of violence and preventing its occurrence. Forensic nursing has become one of the newest and the hottest specialties recognized by the American Nursing Association, and it's growing rapidly in many parts of the world. Forensic nurses provide specialized care for patients who are victims or are perpetrators of trauma. They also have a specialized knowledge of the legal system and skills in injury identification, evaluation, and documentation. A forensic nurse collects evidence, provides medical testimony in court, and consults with legal authorities. Forensic nurses work in a variety of fields, including sexual assault as sexual assault nurse examiners, domestic violence, child abuse and neglect, elder mistreatment, death investigation, and corrections. They may be called in the aftermath of mass disasters and community crisis situations. Only registered nurses can take specialized forensic nursing education. Many forensic nurses have experience in emergency departments, intensive care units, women's health, medical surgical units, or mental health psychiatric units. There are many type of or various specialties in forensic nursing, like sexual assault, interpersonal violence, intimate partner violence, child abuse and neglect, elder abuse and neglect, human trafficking, death investigation, incarceration, refuses with torture, victimization history, mass and natural disasters. Working as a forensic nurse has an excellent written and verbal communication skill to enhance anti-violence efforts. Forensic nurses, including those who work as a sexual assault nurse examiners, communicate with victims, their family members, enforcement, social services, and other entities while trying to bring perpetrators to justice. In the field of forensic nursing, word choice, phraseology, and communication delivery methods can dramatically influence the outcome of legal proceedings, particularly when it comes to a sexual assault. The proper communication is vital to ending violence against women because unaccountable language minimizes the action of abusers and supports blaming victims. Unaccountable language includes phrases like domestic dispute and abusive relationship, which makes situations seem like communication problems rather than violence. Why nurses need communication skills. Interviewing victims, providing information, documenting and relaying information, delivering expert medical testimony, diffusing tense situations by using empathetic and reflective listening skills, forensic nurses diffuse stressful situations so victim can receive competent care. Collaborating with community partners. There is a staggering shortage of nurses who are trained to perform sexual assault examiners. Downing in 2019, ideally every patient has been sexually assaulted should be observed. Sexual assault examiner, however, there are so many nurses who feel comfortable performing these examinations. Mandated by law in India and other countries, all hospitals with an emergency department must have the ability to provide sexual assault examinations, and nurses must have 2 hours of training to perform such examinations. Forensic nurses, on the other hand, are required to have at least 40 hours of classroom training and additional clinical training in their jurisdiction so that they can be competent and for expert experience. Utilizing forensic nurses to perform such examinations reduces the risk of re-victimization that can occur during the evidence collection process, as they are necessary given that one rape is committed each hour in India, with over 8,000 cases reported per year. Unfortunately, the number of forensically trained nurses in the state, especially in the rural areas, is dangerously insufficient to care for this volume of patients. Implementing education and training on trauma-informed care to nurses. Trauma is a result of an event or circumstances that are perceived to be harmful. Its effects are long-term and pervasive. Trauma-informed care embraces a perspective that highlights adaptation over symptoms and resilience over pathology. Trauma-informed care understands and considers the pervasive nature of trauma and promotes environments of healing and recovery rather than practices and services that may inadvertently re-traumatize. Re-traumatize is very dangerous, is any situation or environment that resembles and induces trauma, literally or symbolically, which then triggers difficult feelings and reactions associated with the original trauma. Re-traumatization is often unintentional and is a significant concern. Inducers with multiple trauma experiences often exhibit a decreased willingness to engage in treatment. They are not willing for the treatment. Forensic nurses provide much of the trauma-related care service. In healthcare settings, however, there is a gap in the number of specialty prepared forensic nurses available to provide these services, which are available only about 65% of the time in the hospital emergency departments. Forensic nursing related and trauma informed care content must therefore be incorporated into baccalaureate nursing graduation. The core of general nursing practice is a commitment to patient centered care, because nurse is the key person in the health team, so they must be trained from the student life. Trauma-informed care provides a theoretical framework to allow us to provide effective care that acknowledges that patient we care for bring a history of collective lifetime trauma. Implementing trauma-informed services can assessment, processing, planning, and placement, while also decreasing the risk for the re-traumatization. The implementation may enhance communication between the patient and the treatment provider, thus decreasing risk associated with the misunderstanding the patient reaction and presenting problems, or underestimating the need for appropriate referrals for evaluation or trauma-specific treatment. Trauma-informed care also seeks to introduce compassion and caring into practice, as well as an understanding that everyone can have a traumatic history encounter with the healthcare system. Examples of trauma include, but are not limited to, experiencing or observing physical, sexual, and emotional abuse, childhood neglect, having a family member with a mental health or substance use disorder, experiencing or witnessing violence in the community or while serving in the military, poverty, and systemic discrimination. Traumatic experiences have been linked to chronic pain, mental health problems, poor self-rating health, cardiovascular problems, and other persistent health issues. The connection between traumatic experiences and health issues is not always accounted for in nursing education or practice. Study shows that health providers experience numerous barriers to addressing trauma among patients and report a need for more training in trauma-informed care approaches. In addition, patients often do not recognize the link between trauma and adverse health outcomes. Trauma-informed approaches to care shift the focus from what's wrong with you to what happened to you by realizing the widespread impact of trauma and understanding potential paths for recovery, recognize the signs and symptoms of trauma in individual clients, families, and staff, integrating knowledge about trauma into policies, procedures, and practices, and seeking to actively resist re-traumatization that is avoiding an environment that inwardly reminds patients of their traumatic experience and causes them to experience emotional and biological stress. So repetition has to be avoided. Studies indicate that care providers with training in how to attend to safety and other needs for the patients with traumatic experience histories, but more positive feelings about the care they provide, empowered to address trauma. Making our practices more trauma-informed is necessary and laudable first step, but will be insufficient without larger structure reform. Trauma is not only the result of a single event or even multiple events. It also results from the set of circumstances that found be harmful, like racism, misogyny, xenophobia, religious discrimination, and other forms of systemic and systematic social discrimination are present. Historical realisms that also account for trauma. The emergency department is a frequent entry point into the healthcare system for victims of violence. Currently, knowledge deficit and clinical practice gap exist among emergency nurses regarding their consistent ability to implement a trauma-informed approach in their interaction with the forensic client. Emergency nurses at all levels of professional development should be well informed regarding the prevalence of violence, basic clinical forensic nursing practice, and the principles of the trauma-informed care. Providing trauma training is critical not only for clinical but also for non-clinical employees. Care providers should be well versed in how to create a trusting, non-threatening environment where it is interacting with the victims and the staff. Nurses often have little individual power within the traditional institutional structures. However, collectively, we can have a powerful voice. We should be using our knowledge of the consequences of the trauma, understanding of the full complexities of true trauma-informed practice that centers the needs of our most marginalized patients and our deep patient care experience to advocate for structural change. The practice of trauma-informed care is clearly and easily compatible with the necessary content of baccalaureate nursing education, and it is essential that nurses in the 21st century recognize and attend to the impact of trauma on the patient population. by integrating trauma-informed care into baccalaureate curriculum, nursing educators can provide students with the skills and facility necessary to provide holistic and highly effective care to the most vulnerable patient. So the nurses are the key person in the health team, so we have to be more trained and as a forensic nurse so that we can help to the victims and we can prevent the violence further. Thank you.